of Indonesia has submitted formal protests against supposed U.S. sorties across the Timorese border.
And if Indonesia's government continues to hamper our efforts to combat terror, we will make our displeasure known.
Has effectively driven the Darah Dandoa out of East Timor, crushing individual cells of guerrilla fighters. The situation in Indonesia should be resolved within. Have given U.S. troops for limited sorties onto Indonesian land, but only under supervision by.
I think I need these two nannies. I'm a big boy, you know.
Sam, on this mission, we have to work closely with the local authorities. It's related to the bank account we found on Soth's laptop. A large payment was made to a charity cover-up for a Syrian terrorist cell operating in Jerusalem.
I knew the Penguin was a benefactor, and?
You'll have more details once you get on site, big boy.
Geula District Street Market, Jerusalem, Israel. April 5th, 2006. Oven hours. Identify the biological agent. Third Echelon has linked Suhadi Sadono's Springfield demonstration to the black market purchase of an unknown biological agent. Rendezvous with Israeli intelligence agent Dalia Tal in order to infiltrate the black market. So, greetings to the Earthlings. Welcome back to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell, Pandora Tomorrow. This is pretty much, you know, one of my favorite missions throughout the franchise. One of them, not the most favorite mission, but yeah, one of my most favorite missions throughout the franchise. And definitely my most favorite mission when it comes to the game of Pandora Tomorrow. But, yeah, again, this level still has a lot of switched events just in the fashion of Pandora Tomorrow. There's no escaping that though. However, just to recapitulate on whatever has happened until now, the US Embassy gets attacked in East Timor, and they try to figure out the objective of Darah Dandoa, the terrorist group that attacked the US Embassy. And they find out that they have been active in France. Somebody named Modified Penguin. Dude turns out to be a CIA agent, ex-CIA agent. He has now started working for the terrorists, which is pretty much what Sam confirmed in the previous mission. And he also managed to gather more information from this Modified Penguin person. It turns out that they were planning on something called the Springfield demonstration. And in this briefing right now, we figure out that, we get to know rather, that the Third Echelon has intercepted communications wherein, you know, there was some black market purchase, which was, you know, some sort of a biological agent that was related to the Springfield demonstration. How they did that, I have no idea. But I suppose there are methods that, you know, SIGINT has a lot of methods, signals, intelligence, that us common folk don't really know about. But anyway, without further ado, let's go ahead and play this little game. You can talk to her.
Here's a cultural opportunity for you. The birthplace of Judaism, Christianity, and Islam.
So this is where all that peace and love came from.
Exactly. Recent attacks have led authorities to put a curfew in place, which is what accounts for tonight's peace. In other words, you should have basically empty streets.
Great. The fewer civilians, the easier my job gets.
That being said, there are still quite a lot of civilians in these quarters.
This looks like a touchy mission. Grunton is coordinating with local intelligence.
Mossad?
Even better, Shin Bet.
Spooky. Who are we torturing?
Just you. First thing you're going to need is to retrieve your SC-20K.
Wouldn't it make more sense just to give it to me?
We have the barrel altered to reduce sonic placement. Only one man with those skills in the area. An old arms dealer slash CIA plant working out of the back of a small shop. He'll be waiting for you. Details on your OPSAT.
Yeah, this is a pretty cool mask that the one that Savage is wearing right now. And let me just... Yeah. I'm pretty sure there were some enemies up here. Or were there? Excuse me? Yeah, there is one guard over there that we need to be really cautious about, and I do believe there was another guard over there, just that I can't see him anymore. Now, the amazing thing about being Sam is that you can literally hang off these wards for as long as you need to. Like, he won't get tired of just hanging around there. Now, that guy, I suppose, is giving us a window of opportunity to head forward. I do believe there's somebody here. And yeah, they pretty much just force you to use a lot of the mechanics of Pandora Tomorrow to clear these streets here. Now, given the scripted nature of this game, I don't really have much of an idea about how this is going to go. It's been a long time since I've played Pandora Tomorrow, but I do suppose we should be good to go. I mean, I don't think we are in much of a danger here. Let me just... quick save just in case. Now, there is another guy in front of us, and I don't really know what we need to do to, you know, get past that guy. But I do suppose it involves hiding in this corner over here. And hoping that we do not get caught. Right. I have a feeling that it might have been saved at the wrong time, but over. In any case, patience is a virtue, and we really should be patient. Yeah, I'll just stick here. Hopefully that guy passes me without any issues. And... thankfully nobody saw me, so I'm just gonna go ahead and stick to this corner now. Hopefully this guy won't be able to notice me, but if he does, then well, tough luck. He does not. How fortunate. Let me just go ahead and see if I can slot him, because I'm not particularly sure about this guy here. Now, I don't really recall where to go from here. I'm sure it was not inside that, yeah, it's not there.
העוצר הזה אינו נכפה וגם אינו נשלט. צד שני, המשטרה נראית מאוד מתוחה. בדיוק, הם כבר לא שולטים בכלום. אתה חושב שתהיה עוד התקפה הלילה? אני לא יודע, אבל עדיף שלא נשאר באזור העיר העתיקה. אני יודע, אשתי ואני חושבים לעבור חזרה לתל אביב. נראה שהמצב פחות מסוכן שם. אתה באמת חושב כך? אין מקום מסוכן יותר מירושלים.
Yeah, I have no idea what the graph is saying, but he definitely was saying something. If any of you would be kind enough to translate, that would be amazing. Anyway, quick saving here because I think there's like one brief moment where that guy, where those guys can actually see you. Well, I guess not. Okay. It's a
you cannot stay here. You have to go home.
Let me just finish my orange juice.
You can finish it in prison if you want.
Okay, I'm going. Fine.
Yeah, Goofy's gonna be rough.
I said now.
And this mission is going surprisingly smooth thus far. So I don't really want to jinx it. But right under his nose, huh? Well, I think what we're supposed to do here is jump down so that we can flip. Yeah, we can't exactly go up, so what we need to do is pretty much just jump down. And yeah, this should enable us to sneak a little further. There's like a guard right there that we would ideally want to avoid. Yeah, so I'm not sure about how this level went, but I think SWAT rolls are the way to go. Oh yeah, this is the shop for... Well...
We just want the guns and the money. It's all. We'll take your life too if we have to. But we don't want it. We have no choice. We need to have them dead.
You're Saul Berkovitz.
Oh, thank God you showed up when you did. You are Mr. Brunton's man, no?
Who were they?
Thieves. They shouldn't have been able to get this close to me. There must be something wrong with my security arrangements.
You've got something for me.
Yes. Only a small thanks compared to what I owe you.
I think there's also a section that we really need to hide these bodies, so... Oh yeah, there's my sequence again. Look at that beauty. Complete with ring, all the attachments.
Good. Feeling better with a warm gun in your hand?
Much thanks.
Your next objective is named Dahlia Tal. Brunton?
Ms. Dahlia Tal. She's a Shin Bet agent in deep cover with local terrorist cells.
She's our link to Norman Soth's terrorist connections. One of the choice nuggets of intel we pulled off Soth's laptop. Find Dahlia. She'll lead you to the mercenaries.
I see. I think there was something about hiding these bodies.
You made some modifications.
If you like to give it a try, I know a discreet place nearby.
Well, I actually do not want to give it a try. What about these bodies, though? Do I just leave them here? I don't think so. That does not seem to be a good approach. I mean, I think as far as this game itself is concerned, just like the first Splinter Cell, it is highly recommended that we hide the bodies in shadows so that they aren't found. Although, one thing that I did notice in this game is that when somebody physically stumbles into a body, they do in fact find it. So, yeah. Hopefully that'll be good enough. I don't really want to follow that guy. Let me just go and save it. Now the SIGINT key is actually pretty, you know, useful in this game. The thing about this policeman is I think we can just follow him all the way until the end. Just get out of here, you know, if you want to play it safe, if you don't want to risk it. Whoa, 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 what? Excuse me? Okay. Did this guy's patrol path change just because I was here? Anyway, I'll just head on my way. And hopefully get it done with. I do not suppose he comes here, but then again, I'm not sure. I'm not like 100% certain about that. So yeah, we wait for the nice officer to
leave. Hey, please, can you tell me when the curfew ends?
No idea. We had an incident in the Christian area this morning.
Was it serious?
Pretty serious, but less than the one last week. Now be quiet.
God, this city is becoming more and more dangerous.
Oh yeah, that guy's waiting for me over there. I think street is available. Like, if you follow the cop, that guy more or less, like, if you follow this guy, he just takes you to a shooting range, like an area where you can shoot the gun without being too bothered by folks. Again, another SWAT role. No idea how that guy did not see me. Now, I have mostly forgotten most parts of this game, so yeah, let me just stick to this door here. I don't think she'd be able to notice me if I, you know, stick to the door. But who is this woman walking out in the middle of the night here? Huh, that was close. Also, I would suppose. Okay. Mm-hmm. I am in the darkness again. At least the scripted events in this level don't really feel as trollish as they did in the previous level. Because they were like rough in the previous level. I think to avoid those guys, we should probably just...
People are tired and bored to stay home.
If they prefer to risk their life,
this will never change.
I don't like what happened in the grocery store.
This is almost total anarchy now.
Like,
they will never respect any of the people...
Tried something, it didn't exactly work.
Yes, I will keep on being busy.
Speak for yourself.
Who did it?
Nobody claimed it, but you don't have to think twice to know.
Will there be any reaction?
I guess so. As usual.
Another terrorist attack and the city will blow up.
You know, we've been saying that for so long.
Nothing changes.
Only the number of dead in the list changes. It keeps growing.
Now, do I have to go here? Can I just... Let me try something. I'm gonna try grabbing this thing here. Oh, I can't, of course I can't. So I guess this is pretty much the only way. I was being a little cautious so as to not bump into those guys over there. I think I can go through here. That guy should be alive. Yes, he is. I do not suppose that was the way to go. Or is it through this door here? I wonder. You know what, sir? You look like Nicolad, sir. Yeah, this door is not interactable, so I guess the only way to go is through this window here. So, these kinds of puzzles are pretty much what... Wait, there's somebody over there. Yeah, I think they're smoking a cigarette. Ah, this person saw me, I see. I guess we just gotta wait until this guy finishes his... Yeah. Well, he's done. can't exactly do that either. Yeah, I can't tell how he saw me. Like, he was not supposed to be able to see me, but he did anyway. Okay, way seems clear. Time to keep moving. I don't think that guy who noticed me matters much. I feel like I'm getting close to meeting Darah et al. Now. Darah et al. A fancy name if you ask me. Well, as long as I stick to the shadows, I suppose I'm fine. I suppose this is the only way. Although I could probably climb up here. 3 police officers in total. Maybe I could stick to, you know. Yeah, that is a dead end. No way to go there. I could probably stick to this ledge right here to make it easier on myself. Isn't that like the waltz theme from Around the World in 80 Days? I recently watched this anime called... Well, I forgot the name of the anime. Anthem of the Heart, yeah. And they really use that theme a lot in that anime. So I feel like, yeah, that might just be the theme from the anime itself. Oh, yeah, there was a rope there, wasn't there? The piece of rope that we could have used. Okay. One piggy, two piggy.
Who is that?
Who's who? I think that is a glitch because, yeah, I don't think these people would be able to notice me since I am in the last section of darkness right here. So, yeah, to them, I'm supposed to be unnoticeable. Pretty sure I could have just made it far easier on myself by sticking to the ground instead, but here we are.
Maybe it was nothing.
Yeah, it was nothing. Okay. That's good enough for me. Yep. I'm making a run for it. Fuck you too. I'm through with you. Really? As long as you don't come in this direction. Pretty certain I have to go somewhere here, but just can't figure out where. I guess not this way, but I guess it's supposed to be the other way. Unless it's supposed to be somewhere over there. Where am I supposed to go? Not there either. I don't think I see a way through anywhere. No, I don't think there's a big here either. Let me just go and save here for the sake of saving. In like an alternate slot. I suppose there might be a view here. Ah, yes, right here. For whatever reason, fog tends to light you up like anything. I think that might be down your tower there. So in this area of the level, you might see bright lights like that, a spotlight over there. Yeah, if you look into it with your x-rays on, it's gonna blind you temporarily, of course, but it's gonna blind you nonetheless. And these areas should be clear for the most part. Don't think there are any guards over here. Just that one scripted event that causes you to question sanity. Oops, sorry, wrong button. I meant to drop down. Yeah, if I zipline. So if I look into these lights with my night vision goggles on, they're gonna blind me. Like, they tend to blind you. I do not.
I have a clear identification of Dahlia. She's waiting for you near the church. She's wearing a traditional white outfit. The code is there a special hour for the mass? Answer, only in the morning.
That last section was a little crazy, strange.
Is there a special hour for the mass?
Only in the morning. You took a long time. You're American. Who are you?
I'm friendly and looking for a friend of mine. You've seen this man?
I feel you wouldn't be asking unless I had.
What was he doing in Jerusalem?
Buying a weapon.
Details, details.
I don't know any. Something biological. The Syrians have supposedly had it for over a decade, but it was too dangerous to move until your friend came along with some kind of storage devices.
What was the deal?
Your friend got the biological agent. He gave the Syrians a small mountain of US currency and one of the storage devices.
Where are the Syrians? Where's the device?
I'll take you to the device, but stay out of sight. Anybody sees us together, and we'll be far from the only people killed.
Roger, roger. Control 7 returned to me yet. So I suppose I'm supposed to use this gate to get out? Really? Okay, now the next section is pretty script heavy. Yeah, I suppose this is pretty much the only way for us to go forward without getting detected. I think there might have been other ways, but they are mostly glitched in my game at least, so I suppose I should take the slide out as well, because there's no other way around it. I'll just wait for the scope to disappear. Funny how I didn't notice the light going missing.
What are you doing on the street?
I'm sorry, officer. I'm heading home now.
The curfew is very clear. You're endangering yourself and others.
Of course. But my father, I have to take care of him since he was wounded in one of the attacks. I was changing his bandages and must have lost track of time. I didn't intend...
Ah, I see. Well, hurry home. And be careful.
Thank you, officer. I will.
Well, look at her. Pretty smart, isn't she? Oh no. The officer's coming back. Whatever will I do? Just move out of the way for a few seconds, I guess. Okay, there was another guy in front of me, but I don't really know what to do about that guy. There is Dahlia right there. A near miss, I would say. Sometimes this game is a little erratic in the way it behaves. Like for example, with the shadows and stuff, which is pretty much one of the primary reasons why this game was pulled from most digital storefronts except for, well, Xbox. Only the remastered version was on Steam, and this is another one of those set pieces where you're supposed to do the SWAT rolls. SWAT roll from side to side. And it doesn't matter if they're looking in your direction or not, you won't get noticed anyhow. This is one of the cooler moments of this game, but not exactly the most impressive. I mean, that I feel like is a good summary of what Pandora Tomorrow is, like full of cool moments, but not terribly impressive. How did that guy just let her through? Interesting. I wonder why Dahlia Tal took the long route around. Probably should hurry along.
What are you doing outside? We're well past curfew.
I'm so sorry. I just had to take care of my sick father. He was wounded in...
Of course, but we can't make exceptions. I'll have to insist you return to your house immediately.
Of course, officer. I'll be right on my way.
I'll escort you.
Excuse me?
These streets aren't safe, curfew or no. I'll walk you home to make sure you arrive quickly and safely.
That's not necessary.
I don't mind at all. Here, let's go.
That really won't be necessary.
Okay, badass Dahlia Tal, but that's like a very crude move that she pulled there. Like, I couldn't even see what that was, like a body kick of some sort?
Nicely done. Does this change our plan?
No. The biological sample will only be at the Shoshana warehouse for another few hours. We can't afford to let it get away. We just need to be more subtle. If I see you between here and the warehouse, I'll have to call off my part of the assignment.
Right. Is there a way I could get up on the roofs?
Yeah, that works. Over there, you should be able to get up. I'll meet you at the warehouse.
Over there? So apparently, suddenly she's an enemy as well? But I suppose that foreshadows something, doesn't it? I mean, even though I know I probably have this game, it's something else. Now, how do I get to the roof? I wonder, the rooftops. Anyway, I guess I'll just try going this way. I see something over here. Another officer, of course. I have no clue whether this is the right way to go or not, but I'm just going to go for it. Ah, yes, the way to the rooftop. Wait, I suppose this was supposed to go to the rooftop. But I suppose this does. There are a few people there. I overstepped a little. And now I must start all the way from here. Some nice Israeli folks watching the credits scene, watching the credits roll by. I mean, must be really nice people to actually sit around and watch credits roll by. I don't think I've ever heard of anybody who voluntarily watches credits, or at least credit sequences and scenes in pretty much any media. Let me just go ahead and reinforce my savior while I can. Rattle on the wall, and we'll take this time to go down. So that wall up ahead looks scalable, this thing here, but yeah, I'll probably just have to stay here hidden in the shadows while Dahlia walks past me.
Miss, excuse me.
Oh, thank goodness, a police officer. You startled me.
You can't be...
I was so worried because of the curfew. Imagine the type of character you could run into out here.
You need to...
I'm sorry, but I really need to get home. I shouldn't be out past curfew.
Exactly, miss.
Thank you so much. Have a good night, officer.
Just tell them everything there is to hear. Okay, managed to get here because there's not really... there aren't really many other places that I can go from there. But the question now is, how do I get past this guy? Because get past him, I do have to. I suppose I can use this corner here. Don't really see any other way here, so I suppose that's the only way right now. Smooth, if I say so myself. I think that is the weirdos that she's talking about, and yeah, that's Talia Tal right there. I wonder if there's anything up here. Ah, yes, more. I wonder who kept these here, because, I mean, if they could have just kept the stuff here, might as well just, you know, keep it all here. Sticky shocker, and that's just legal, nothing that we need to be, yeah, concerned about. I wonder what's up there though. I'll check that out later, but for this playthrough, well, let's just say I'm not going to be following Lambert's orders down to the letter. Just because I want this playthrough to be a no-kill playthrough, so yeah. Ooh, a hidden elevator, look at this, wow. I mean, I say no-kill playthrough, but I am gonna have to kill shortly anyway, but I don't want to spoil things for you. Just how much venom can be hidden in a beauty. We're about to find out soon.
Who do the Syrians think you are?
A double agent. They think I'm betraying Mossad.
Why are you being so helpful?
Our governments are allies. Our enemies are yours.
Interesting.
You don't have to come to the warehouse. Teamwork isn't exactly my... M.O.
You can take it up with your superiors. Brunton, I believe his name was.
She knows a lot. And am I missing something here?
You ready? We're stirring up a nest of vipers here.
You want to come inside?
Not on your life.
Fisher, we need Dahlia Tal dead. Kill her. Don't think, just do it.
Even though we had ample opportunity to decide not to do that, I elected not to.
Damn it, Fisher. We needed her dead.
Why?
Shinbet's not playing a straight game.
It's not your job to question.
I'm going to need a little more warning to shoot unarmed women. Are we aborting the mission?
No, we can't. But you just dug yourself a deep pit to climb out of. Sign off, Brunton. We need to talk.
Get the sample as soon as possible. You're in a Fifth Freedom situation. All means are acceptable.
So yeah, we don't really have to bother about the alarms anymore. It's sort of strange to see that this was not the Splinter Cell where... Yeah, let's keep hiding the shadows. That is probably Sam Fisher's photo. Let's not disturb that bit of philosophy of hiding the shadows, because I think I sort of just might have dug myself into a bit of trouble right here. I mean, I did take a lot of hits, and I do not have any health kits either, so... Even though I have sticky shockers equipped, I'm not certain I'm going to use them. So, it is at this point in the game that if you are careful... When I say careful... I'm unable to find a chance to finish my sentence, but what I've been trying to say is if you're good at this, you know, exploiting Splinter Cell, you can... pretty much find a way to get bypass this level without shedding a drop of blood. I believe Center Strain 01 did just that, but sadly I'm not Center Strain 01. And yeah, these levels are just more or less rigged to be action heavy, so you're gonna fall into trouble quite often. And ooh, that was nice. That was a nice choice of me, a nice choice on my part to try and take that light out, because otherwise we would have been out of bullets right there. I tried going past them without taking them out, but it proved to be more and more difficult as time passed. I'm gonna have to take you out as well. Ah, lucky you. You get to live while your friends are dead. Now, ouch. Finally, I think these can be taken out as well. I'm not certain. Yeah, apparently these can't. But at any rate, yeah. So yeah, there is a way to play this game without ever, you know, shedding a single drop of blood, but I for one do not know how to do that, and it sort of sucks that Sam doesn't know how to... Anybody else? No? Yeah, so it sort of sucks how flashback. Nice. Oh, that was a shaft grenade. Okay, a frag grenade. Lots of stuff here. Lots of stuff that we can take. A good thing we. Can you please pick it up? Thank you. Like, there's lots of stuff here, and. That we are getting at this point anyway. Some health as well. I do not think this was one of the areas where we needed to come. I just went over the sample. Cool. I do not think the sample was anywhere here anyway, but I just came into Well, refill my health, I guess. I don't know why I came in here, to be honest. Yeah, I'm just gonna leave the body there as is. These seem to be some sort of catacombs. Oh yeah, that's where the wire sample is. Similar looking place, but a different place. And I'm pretty sure there are some... Okay, this part of the mission is proving to be far harder than I thought it would. This guy wasn't dead? Really? And here I thought I just had the name. Turns out I was wrong. I guess, stealth has no place in this mission.
We've got some bad intercepts, Fisher. You ever read the Chamberlain chapter of your history books?
No need to act cute.
Dahlia Tau is close and no doubt eager to repay your mercy.
Shinbet wants the ND-133 and knows there's no official repercussions for killing somebody who doesn't officially exist.
She's got sniper stats that could disprove Kennedy conspiracies. Needless to say.
Yeah, you said jump and I didn't. When I get back to the States, I'll sit facing the corner in a cone hat.
The voice, you know, the script writing and the voice acting inside the... What do you call it? The game is amazing, but... it just sucks in the cutscenes. Is there nobody here? I was expecting somebody here, to be honest. Interesting. I really was expecting somebody there. But did they just up and dissolve them? Where are these people? Ah, right here. I see you. Oh no.
Who is there?
Really? All three of my sticky shockers just bounced off this wall with a bad collision detector. And what about you? Are you gonna be as easy to kill? I guess you will. I suppose stealth has its place in this level then. And this is the elevator that we wanted to come back to. Or so I suppose. The problem isn't over yet because there are snipers up there which we need to watch out for, so yeah. I wonder why that middle level was ever there, you know? There's like this level in the middle which you can't really access, but it's there nonetheless. Now the question is, how did Dahlia know that we would be here? Okay, why is the game... Yeah. I was wondering, why is the game lagging all of a sudden? Turns out it wasn't the game, it was me. It was I who was lagging. Yeah, apparently there's Dahlia right there, in case you guys can't tell. Missed out, along with... another one of the snipers, and luckily they haven't seen me this far, So I hope to keep it this way. Let's see how much trial and error that takes. I know for a fact they cannot see me at this corner right here. Okay. Note to self, do not get too close to the fire. Otherwise you risk being seen by the snipers. Now I wonder how I make it through without being seen by the snipers. For certain I could follow the shadow up till here, but how do I cross the shadow, I wonder? Now, there is one sniper right here that I can see in front of me, and those are like just a pair of jeans. But Dahlia is looking the other way, I don't know where the other sniper is, if there is even another sniper. Oh yeah, there is. There's one more sniper right there. Okay. So I think I can proceed through here without alerting anybody. Are you looking at me? No, you're not. Good. I don't know what Dahlia's looking at, but as long as it's not me, that's fine. That was not nice. Well, all eyes on me now. I wonder if I just have to go ahead and use the nuclear option because, yeah, there's just way too much light around the scene for me to resort to any kind of... Yeah, that light cannot be broken, so that is like a major light right there in the scene. That is also like a lot of light right there. Did I just make that shot? Not enough lights have been taken out. I mean, the scene's still lit completely, so I guess all I can do is just use the SC20K in the sniper function to target these guys right here. Well, Dahlia, I originally did not intend to kill you, but I suppose now I must. Keep looking, Dahlia. He won't be able to figure out where I am. Not anytime soon. Oh. Who's shooting at me now?
You and Cohen can get out of there. Mission's complete.
You think that smallpox is the real thing?
I hope to God not. There's certainly been suggestions in Syrian intelligence that they've been developing agents. All we can do is let Bellagio do his job, and hope.
You think smallpox is the Springfield demonstration?
I don't want to guess. Meet Cohen and get out of there. Your soft spot for Dahlia has cost us more in the region than you can imagine.
Well, even though I did not kill Dahlia in this mission, I ended up killing her. So... I'm pretty sure there is a way to do this mission without killing anybody, but I personally don't know how to do that. And awesome soundtrack nonetheless, pretty amazing soundtrack, solid soundtrack designed by, I don't know who designed these soundtracks, but amazing soundtrack design. Let's head on to the debriefing. Geula District Street Market, Jerusalem, Israel, April 5th, 2006, 02:13 hours. Mission complete. Using devices stolen from Sonya Cryogenics, the NT-133, Soth has made a Syrian-developed strain of the smallpox virus highly portable. Sadono is now in possession of an unknown number of easily concealed biological weapons, and the plot hence becomes revealed. Shinbet wants the weapons for themselves, so they pretty much just, you know, decide to fuck us over. And that's pretty much the part of Jerusalem mission. I mean, even though the infiltration in this mission is charming as hell, yeah, they sort of take the entire thing into plummet, into a nosedive when they introduce the shootout sections. And yeah, I honestly believe that the game would be far better without those sections. But yeah, to each their own. That's all that we realized from this level. We have got no further information whatsoever. We just realized that the NT-133 was, in fact, a smallpox virus, a modified smallpox virus. And yeah, the terrorists have their hands on an unknown amount of samples. What I do not understand is how Sam got to figure out what the biological sample was, how he got to understand that it was the smallpox virus, because he does say to Lambert in the end that it is a smallpox virus sample. But I wonder how he knew all of a sudden that that was smallpox indeed. The Third Echelon doesn't have the hands of the sample to have analyzed it by now, and Sam, I don't think Sam has microscopes built into his eyes, but I think I'm just, splitting hairs at this point, if you could say that. So, yeah. That was that for this level. Thank you for watching, thank you for tuning in, and the next time we come over to Splinter Cell Pandora Tomorrow, I don't know when that'll be, but I'm hoping soon, sooner than this video anyway. When that happens, we will be covering the next mission, which I think, I don't remember what the next mission is anymore, but we'll see when we come back to the next mission. So until then, take care. Farewell, fellow things.